A city in lockdown and an industry at flashpoint. As a tradie war erupts outside the CFMEU's Elizabeth Street headquarters. These construction workers say they're fighting back against forced vaccination. Their anger aimed at their own union. After a 7-hour standoff, it exploded at 4 p.m. when heavily armed police arrived.
And the police behind us, we need to
Police were pelted with bottles. Staff trapped inside used hoses in a desperate attempt to clear the mob. Furious workers descended on their union around 9 this morning to vent over a looming deadline. If they don't have at least one vaccine dose or a booking to get one, they can't work. Yes! Union boss John Setka urged protesters to calm down, denying the union backs mandatory vaccines and suggesting not everyone in the crowd was a union member. That just enraged the workers more.
Half these people, if they were out of work for a week, they'd be crawling back on their hands and knees for a job. They haven't made any sacrifices at all, and they're not really unionists. They're just the scum of the earth as far as I'm concerned.
There'd be a whole bunch of people who are at home because their industry's shut and they'd be scratching their heads.
I mean, the Premier's roadmap clearly states that there's going to be this new segregated underclass in society that won't be able to work, they won't be able to participate, they won't be able to go to the pub, they won't be able to take part in society, and people are upset about it.
The protest numbers swelled as the hours ticked by. Workers brawled amongst themselves. Oh! CFMEU windows were smashed, glass was kicked in, police standing face to face with builders, bringing city traffic to a standstill.
Items are being thrown towards the police, so we're just going to stick back and...
I need you out of our way.
But the Premier is standing by his vaccine ultimatum.
Industry would have to operate under different settings, and no doubt I would get advice that it had to be closed. I wouldn't want to do that.
A high-vis anti-vax show of force as the construction industry faces a COVID crisis.
Paul Dowsley, 7 News.